A few weeks ago, I reviewed the Reolink Argus 4 Pro camera, which I thought was pretty good, but because it was battery powered, it wasn't really possible to integrate it with Home Assistant without the Reolink Home Hub. So Reolink have sent me a couple of their mains powered cameras, just so as I can demonstrate to you how well they play with Home Assistant. So this isn't a review video of the cameras at all. It's going to be part tutorial, but mostly a demonstration of what is possible and what functionality you get when you connect Reolink's cameras to Home Assistant. But it's difficult to talk about all of that without actually showing off the cameras themselves. First of all, we have the RLC-810WA, which is a bullet style camera that supports either wired Ethernet or dual band Wi-Fi 6. It has 4K resolution, color night vision, infrared night vision, and ultra bright LEDs. Then there's the CX810, which is one of Reolink's newest products. This is wired Ethernet only and supports power over Ethernet. It does not have infrared night vision, but it does still have color night vision, and to see why that might be a good idea, we need to compare the specs. Both cameras have a 4K resolution, but the CX810 supports a higher frame rate. Honestly, that's not an important detail though, because for security footage, you don't really need anything higher than 15 frames a second. We're not shooting a movie here. But the CX810 does support HDR, so you can see more detail in the shadows, and importantly, it has a much larger image sensor, which really boosts low light level performance. It also has a wider and taller field of view, helping it capture a wider area. Both cameras have a weatherproof slot for a micro SD card, or you can connect them to an NVR for centralized storage. I have set up both cameras side by side, pointing in the same direction in order to make their comparison as fair as possible. So here is me standing outside. I'm about 15 meters away from the cameras. This is the RLC-810A, and you can see if I zoom in to me, it's still pretty clear at that distance. You can definitely identify me. And here's the same shot from the CX810, just as clear but with a wider viewing angle. Perhaps the colours are more accurate on this one too. If I zoom in to me, then you can still see a lot of detail. I stuck a little picture on a table in the shot so as we can compare the clarity of text, so I'll show them side by side. The CX810, in my opinion, is clearly better at displaying the text. That means it's likely to be better at picking out things like car number plates. Now, the CX810 claims to be excellent in low light and does not include any infrared LEDs, so you can't make a claim like that and not expect me to put it to the test. For this test, I have disabled the spotlight LEDs because I want to properly test how well it deals with no light. Potentially, I might want to use this sort of camera at the front of my house, and I wouldn't want any visible spotlight LEDs turning on because that would be really annoying to my neighbours. Let's start off at 10:30 PM. The lights in my house are still on and bleeding through the window into the conservatory. The CX810 is clearly a lot better in these conditions than the RLC-810A, which is struggling a bit. Both are still in full colour mode though, which is brilliant, and you can read the text on my sign. Half an hour later and the lights are off. The CX810 is struggling now. You can see where there is some light outside, there's some detail. You can pick out the trees still and some fence panels. The RLC-810A, on the other hand, has switched into infrared night vision and my whole garden is fully visible, as is everything in the conservatory. Okay, so here my old cameras are still active outside, putting out some infrared, so that's helping a bit here, but even so, I'm impressed. Zooming into my sign, and under infrared, the text is barely visible now, but under colour night vision, you can just about make it out still due to the contrast against the white background. Moving forward to 1 AM now in full darkness, and colour night vision has become pointless. You can see the odd spot of light here and there, but apart from that, nothing. The infrared camera though is as good as before. These videos were taken at the same time, and you can see on the infrared one that my cat is standing there cleaning herself. That's impossible to see on the CX810 because it's pitch black. Right then, you've seen the cameras I'm using, and they're both pretty decent quality in daylight. I'm not convinced colour night vision is a good idea. It's a shame the CX810 is lacking infrared LEDs because it's otherwise a much better camera. But anyway, this video is about making use of them in Home Assistant. Now, first of all, you need to make sure that you've added these cameras to the Reolink app, whether that is using iOS or Android. It's a simple process. Just make sure that they're plugged into power and a wired network. You scan the QR code on the label and they should just appear. By default, these cameras will only talk to the app or the Reolink desktop software. In order to use them with third-party products, we have to enable some extra features. These features are disabled by default for security reasons, but you can only enable them using the Reolink desktop software. Visit Reolink's website at the URL on screen right now. I'll put this down in the description for you too. I'm on macOS, so I've downloaded and installed that version, but there is also a version for Windows too. I strongly recommend you give your cameras a reserved IP address in your router if you know how to do that, because you don't really want the IP address changing randomly if you rebooted your router for some reason. Either way, open up the Reolink software and add a new camera. So in this demo, we're going to configure the CX810. So you open the Reolink software and hopefully it should scan and automatically find your camera there in this list. But if it doesn't, you can click on the little plus button and scan for it here. And then we just want to add it. It's obviously saying it already exists because it's already detected it here. So I'm going to close. Incorrect username and password because it's just detected it. So the default username is admin. The password is the one that you used when you set it up in the Reolink app. So I'm going to do that and it should connect straight through. There we go. Now, once you've got it working, you need to go to this little cog here and we go down to network, over to advanced, and server settings. Now we're going to enable HTTP and confirm, so that's normal unencrypted HTTP web access. You can enable HTTPS if you want to. There are a few added complications there because it needs to use a certificate and it might not be a trusted certificate by default. HTTP is a lot easier to set up, which is why I'm going to do it in this demo, but you should only do that if you're doing this on a trusted local network. If anybody else is coming into the network, or if this is a public network, then you should use HTTPS. Right, we enable that, we click on save, and then we can close that down. Now, next thing we need to do, we need the IP address of the camera. Network information. Okay, 192.168.1.178 is the IP address of this camera. So let's remember that. We go over to a web browser. http://192.168.1.178, and it's not secure, but that's fine. Admin, and then the password, and I've read and understood the policy. Login. You should now have, there we go, a web interface accessing the camera.
Using that web interface, you can enable things like RTSP and ONVIF too, which allow you to integrate the camera with third-party NVR solutions like Synology's surveillance station. But more importantly, as far as this video is concerned, we are now ready to add the camera to Home Assistant.
Sometimes Home Assistant will automatically detect your camera, sometimes it doesn't, but in this case it hasn't detected it. So I'm going to go down to Settings, Integrations, Add an Integration. We're going to add the Reolink integration. Okay, admin is the username, and then you put your password in there, then you put in the IP address of the camera, and the same one that you used to go to the web interface of the camera, and click on submit. Shouldn't take long. There we go, detected it. So click on finish. Let's go and see what we have got. So the Reolink IPNVR camera integration is there with one device found. All right, okay, so we've got lots of useful things here. We can turn the floodlight on and off. I'm not going to do the siren though, because that could get very noisy. Let's turn that off. We've got sensors here for when it detects motion. So you've got the main motion sensor, which would detect motion at any time or from anything. You've got a motion sensor for when it detects animals, a motion detector for people and for vehicles. We've also got the image display here, so we can actually view a preview. So this is the Fluent display, which is Home Assistant, not Home Assistant, Reolink lingo for their low quality image.
Yeah, you can actually add the clear version if you wanted to enable that, so you could have full quality video in there if you wanted to. It's not enabled by default. If we scroll down to the configuration, you can control the sensitivity of the motion detection. You can see whether the firmware is up to date or not. You can change the mode of the floodlight, whether it's adaptive or on a schedule. And the general motion sensitivity, you can set whether it's recording to the SD card internally, and the volume of the speaker that's on board. There is quite a lot available to play with on the camera.
So what practical use are these sensors and controls to you? Well, I'm planning to put one of these cameras in my back garden. I've got two cats who are always walking around, so the AI detection of humans is specifically going to be useful. I can create an intruder detection automation. My house already has an automation that detects if everyone has gone to bed at night and turns on a special mode to signify that. I can put together an automation which will trigger if the AI human motion detection sensor detects something. It will only run when my house is in night mode, and it'll send a critical notification to my iPhone, breaking through the do not disturb setting. Anyway, your imagination is the limit once you have the cameras connected, so please leave a comment with your ideas and suggestions. There are so many sensors and controls available for these cameras that they are a home automation geek's dream. And don't forget, this is a totally local connection to the camera. There's no cloud involved at all. I'll put links to both products down in the description in case you want to take a look. A massive thank you to my channel members listed here for supporting my channel. It's really appreciated. If you'd like to get benefits like early access to my videos, then please check out the link in the description to find out how you can become a channel member too. Please give this video a like and subscribe to my channel for free to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.